Well, the book of Philemon is Paul's shortest letter, but its message is profound. It's a message of forgiveness and reconciliation. You see, the letter was written directly to an individual named Philemon, who lived in Colossae. And Paul's writing this letter in prison around 60 AD, the same time that Paul wrote Ephesians and Colossians. And Paul writes to his friend Philemon, who he met a few years before during his time in Ephesus. And so before we jump into any of that, let me give you a little backstory. You see, Philemon was a wealthy Roman citizen who, after hearing the good news of the gospel, begins to follow Jesus. Now, at the time, Colossae was under Roman rule, and wealthier Roman citizens often owned slaves. And we aren't told how many slaves Philemon owns, but we do learn that one of them was named Onesimus. And Onesimus is treated like any other slave would have been treated at this time, until one day, we read that Onesimus steals something very valuable from Philemon and decides to run away. Now, before any of this happens, we also learn that Philemon had become a leader of a church that he started in his own home. And starting this church probably had a radical effect on Philemon's life, his personhood, his character. And so it's likely that Onesimus couldn't help but take notice of this. So once Onesimus wrongs his master, he probably feels scared. You see, in Roman culture, stealing from your master could mean severe punishment. You could be thrown into prison, or you could even be killed. So I'm sure part of Onesimus wondered how on earth he was gonna get back into right standing with Philemon, if Philemon could ever even forgive him. Onesimus knew he needed help. So he ran to the one he knew already had a radical impact on Philemon's life, and that's Paul. And so as Onesimus gets to Paul, Paul's under house arrest, and Onesimus ends up staying with Paul, becoming a beloved servant, an assistant, and a friend to him. Onesimus receives the gospel for himself and becomes a follower of Jesus. And now that Paul has come to know the dispute between Onesimus and Philemon, Paul understands the responsibility that not only he has, but that Onesimus and Philemon have to reconcile with one another as followers of Jesus. But Paul knows that this is a tall order, and that's why he writes this letter. Paul writes the book of Philemon to show us the heart of forgiveness and reconciliation. And so now that you've got a little bit of context and some of the backstory, let's take a look at the structure of the book. The book of Philemon can be broken up into four different parts. Paul's greeting, which we often see in his letters. Then Paul transitions into gratitude for Philemon. And after expressing that gratitude, this is where Paul really begins to contend for forgiveness and reconciliation between Onesimus and Philemon, offering Philemon counsel and wisdom on how to do that. And finally, Paul's conclusion. And so after greeting Philemon, Paul begins his letter with a prayer of gratitude that reminds Philemon's heart of the mission that they're both a part of and the partnership that he and Paul share together in Jesus. And the important word here is partnership. Paul reminds Philemon that even though we don't spend a lot of time together and we may not have a lot in common, we both follow the same Jesus. And that actually makes us more in common and brings us closer together than any other thing in the universe. And Paul even tries to highlight this by saying, "I'm sending him back to you, Onesimus, who is my very heart." So Paul's trying to counsel Philemon to help him understand that because of their shared belief in Jesus, Philemon and Onesimus are now equals. They're no longer slave and master, they're now brothers, a part of the same family in Jesus. And so Paul insists on Philemon forgiving Onesimus and receiving him back as a brother, to not just cancel the debt of Onesimus, but to credit his account. And Paul says, "Perhaps the reason he was separated from you for a little while was that you might have him back forever, no longer as a slave, but better than a slave, as a dear brother." Paul goes on to leverage that word partner. And he says to Philemon that if you consider me a partner, welcome Onesimus back as you would welcome me back. And this is where Paul really models what it means to not only represent, but to represent Jesus to others. In fact, Philemon is the only letter that Paul writes where he doesn't mention the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus because he doesn't need to. Instead, Paul models what this looks like. He's modeling the meaning of the cross by standing in place of the one at fault. And Paul says, "If he's done you any wrong or owes you anything, charge it to me." Paul's willing to take on the debt and stand in place of the punishment for Onesimus, the same way that Jesus stood in place of you and me and offered us grace, undeserved favor. And now he's asking Philemon to do the same, and he's confident that he will. The book of Philemon reminds us that in Jesus, every offense can be forgiven. Every conflict can be mended and every broken relationship can be brought back to its fullness. It reminds us of our restored identity, our reconciled relationship, and our redeemed purpose, which part of that purpose is to give to others the grace and forgiveness that we've received in Jesus.